3 minutes to play in the preliminary final.
This is what it's about. Preliminary final, everything on the line, basket for basket.
There's a sense of deja vu about today's clash. These same two sides played off last year for the chance to take on Bendigo in the grand final.
They have knocked out the defending champions on their home court.
The visitors stole the show and the shot at the trophy, but this year the Rangers are out to douse the fire in the preliminary final of the WNBL. You haven't stumbled onto a replay of last year's preliminary final. Once again, the Dandenong Rangers are hosting the Townsville Fire. It's sudden death, WNBL style. And the scene is set at Dandenong Basketball Stadium. The two sides finished on equal points at the end of the regular season, but finals, as we know, are a whole new ballgame. Hello, I'm Stephanie Brands. It's great to have you with us for what is set to be an action-packed afternoon. Laurie Chiswick is buckled up and ready to roll. Laurie, before we look at today's game, congratulations on the news this week that you're officially part of the Opals coaching team.
Oh, thanks very much, Steph. It's going to be a very busy but exciting 8 months ahead.
Yeah, can't wait. And Laurie, first of all, we've got a very big game here. We've turned back the clock. And, well, you'd have to say the odds are probably with Dandenong, but in this particular fixture, history favours Townsville.
Well, I'd like to say it's an easy calculation, but nothing's easy in this. But if you'd have to think that if Dandenong bring their A game, play to their potential, home court advantage, you think that they would win this game. But there's no other team that would rather spoil the party than the Townsville Fire like they did last year. So I think they would come in with a lot of confidence as well.
Well, it was even a similar road to get to today. Let's have a look at how it finished up in the semi-finals. And once again, Townsville, they progressed after a hard-fought semi, defeating Melbourne by just 5 points.
Oh, my goodness, Steph. With 70 seconds to go, Melbourne were up by 1 point. It was so exciting. And we know that Townsville just steadied and were able to come away with that five-point win and make this trip here to Dandenong.
Well, and Dandenong, they faded in their match once again to give Bendigo the right to host the grand final once more, and they've put themselves back in the last chance salute today.
Well, that game really was because of Bendigo's strong defense in the second half that got them there. So it'll be interesting to see if Dandenong made those adjustments and is ready to go today.
I'll tell you who's ready to go. That's all the fans and Peter Mercado in commentary. Peter.
Thank you, Stephanie Brands, and it is loud inside this venue, a packed house at the Dandenong Basketball Stadium. There is the Townsville Fire. Let's take a look at the starting fives for both teams, and here's the Dandenong lineup, a familiar lineup that we've seen all throughout the season. Leilani Mitchell down on her usual numbers. Jenna O'Hay, superstar, supported well by Alice Kunick and Kayla Pedersen there as well. And you can see plenty of depth on that bench. The Townsville Fire lineup, Rachel McCulley, she's going to play a 300th game if they can make the grand final. Well supported by Michaela Cox and that last name, number 8, Susie Bakovic. What a season she's had. In certainly the leader for the MVP for mine at the moment. And plenty of depth as well on the bench, including the Rookie of the Year, Alex Wilson. As the teams make their way out onto the floor, we're not too far away from a start in this one. There is Mark Wright, who's had plenty to talk about his team from last week. He was less than happy with their performance. I didn't mind telling everyone.
Well, it looks like he decided not to have a shave between last week maybe and this week sporting the facial hair. But I tell you what, Peter, there is such energy in the crowd when they were doing their warm-up, the players. You could just, it's different when it's finals time.
Here we go, the preliminary final. 2 years in a row, it's Dandenong and Townsville live from the Dandenong Basketball Stadium. There are our referees for this afternoon. Tip control goes to the Townsville Fire. And there is a huge fire contingent here. Missed pass intended for Michaela Cox. First turnover of the game.
A little bit of nerves there. It wasn't so much that the great defense. I think just that little bit of a nervous start for Townsville.
Desperate to get the W again. Oh, hey, good pass over the top. We're going to see a lot of that. Alice Kunick makes two. Amazing run that this Rangers team have had over the fire. Signified the good things in playoffs basketball. Here's Bakovic one-handed. We'll go the line for a couple.
It'll be interesting to see how Danny Nong, and there was talk all week of how you defend Susie Bakovic. Do you double, triple team her, make her get it out of her hands, force her players to shoot from the outside, or you just have that one-on-one coverage and, you know, rely on your other players to stop the likes of Cox and McCulley?
24 points last week, led all scorers.
I think no matter which way you do it, she's going to find a way to score, Susie.
Exactly. One of the issues will be, one of the things for the Fire to focus on will be looking at slowing the Rangers down, making sure they use their full 24 seconds, controlling the tempo. Here's Mitchell for three. No good. Bakovic with a strong rebound. I like, far away.
I like the fact that Mitchell's looking to try and get involved early. I think she's been pretty quiet the last few games. Would probably be a little bit disappointed in her game. We know that she's in the All-Star 5 and she's produced great numbers, and they need to see that here from her this afternoon.
Michaela Cox for the triple. No good, but they get the rebound back underneath. Hudlevic scores two. Here's Ohay. Looking to get the Rangers moving. They're a quick team. Novosel, jumper two, off target. Uncontested rebound this time for Susie. Cox works it inside Bakovic. Cox again under the basket. Need to flick it back out. Unfamiliar territory for Susie, the triple. And that was the result that you're expecting. Here's Novosel quickly into the front court. Ohay, all on her own.
You cannot leave Jenna Ohay alone at the three-point line at any stage of the game, let alone at the beginning, and let her get the feel of the ball.
16 points last week in the loss to Bendigo. Here's McCulley going all the way. Off the window, no good. And Kunick picking up the rebounds. Working with Mitchell. Really close starts. Early stage of this one. Mitchell going for it. That'll help her confidence, Laurie.
Absolutely, and that's the second one we've seen her put up. Just a little use of that on ball. One way, then the other. A rescreen and a nice shot. Nice balance shot.
So chance here for the Fire. 10 on the shot. Bakovic works with McCulley. We've cut inside. McCulley again takes them all on. Oh, that was nicely done. Rachel McCulley.
That was a tough basket because Alice Kunick was riding her the whole way there and then has that height advantage and had that long arm.
Here's Mitchell. Works across the floor. Ella Pedersen, ball inside. Mitchell again, off target. Kunick goes down behind play.
To take advantage of this 5-on-4.
And they do.
Susie Bakovic running. Rim to rim, which is what you want to do out there. Nice feed inside.
Remembering Danny Nong lead the head-to-head this season, 3-0. Had some big wins along the way. Their first meeting was 3 points, then 15 points and 20 points across the course of the season. Oh, hey, long range, front of the iron. Good rebounding again by the Fire. Pedlovic works with McCulley. To Steph Cumming. Under all sorts of pressure. Well done again by Jenna Ohay. The Fire retain possession. Looking to work inside. Having lost a handle on it, they retain possession from the baseline with 8 seconds on the shot clock.
Great defensive pressure by Danny on getting in those lanes, being disruptive, deflecting the ball. That's exactly what you want.
All in. Cox works with Susie. Five of the shot. Tip strip to the ball by Ohay. Rangers, a little untidy, but this will work out okay. Natalie Novosel makes two.
Well, you have to say they went with the tact of everybody defending Susie. She had four defenders on her at that last basket.
Steph coming with it. Ball over the top. Dangerous, but this should work out okay. Vladovic puts it up. In fact, it was Cox that put it up, made the two.
Rosie Vladovic's having a great start to this game. She's playing some really good minutes.
Here's Mitchell, works it across to Ohay, ball inside, Pedersen, just a jumper two, off target. Mark Wright talked about their shooting percentages and how they were well down last week and wanting to improve it. Here's a long range three from Cumming!
I think that was a two, her foot was just on the line.
Rotuart. Really lead to Townsville. Last week they were pushed all the way by the Melbourne Boomers. Here's Kunek driving baseline. And the foul. Tiffany Levick getting the foul. That is her first personal. And we've got ourselves a timeout. Five to play. It's Townsville by three in the prelim final. And we're going to get inside and have a listen to the Chris Lucas huddle. Just put through the ringer last week. Let's have a listen to him here.
Okay. Defensively, there's no question Mitchell's trying to go to work, okay? So our ball screen D's got to be on it. High split, low split, okay? Be dynamic there, okay? Make sure we move our feet, be in plugging position. Get to the shooters. Kunik, her up fake is so quick, don't even react to it, all right? She's either shooting it or she's driving it. Either way, all right, you'll be fine with that. Okay, next set here, run a 35. But we're looking for Rach on the post up, okay? If we haven't got it, Mick, you'll be into the ball screen. You're starting the three spot. Yep, and then we got action there. So look for the post up first. Right, where we go.
Well, what do you make of that, Laurie?
Well, I'll be interested to see if Rachel McCauley looks to, I think what Chris is talking about, post up Leilani Mitchell. That's their first look, and then it's using the on-ball screen. But they certainly talked about how Mitchell was looking to go to work on them. They needed to defend that on-ball screen. They needed to be dynamic in their split line help.
Well, Leilani Mitchell has 2 points at the moment. She's made just 3 of 17 shots in her past two games. So she's been very quiet and needs plenty of assists to lift her team. Steph Brands, you were having a listen to the Rangers huddle.
Yeah, indeed. Relatively happy with their defense. Big message, though, is Mark Rudd's very concerned about them giving up easy baskets.
Ball back in, Ardossi crunched by Susie, who's not happy. Never known a player to be happy with a foul, though. I should just point that out. Only 3 fouls for the game so far. So, hey, with 10 on the shot clock. In range, Mitchell fakes. He's going to push inside. Kunek back out. Oh, hey, long bomb. Rebound by Cox. The far away. Townsville allowed the Rangers to shoot 49%. Successful for field goal range. 43%. 3-point line. Here's McCauley finding some space. Just couldn't finish it.
Well, they executed the way they called. Chris Lucas called in that timeout. Just weren't able to finish.
Leilani going to the rack. Is fouled.
Well, that's a good foul for Dandenong to get against Susie. That's her second now. She's going to have to come out of the game.
And she sits. Kayla Standish checking in. Now, she had some injury concerns last week on her shoulder. Went down in the second quarter, but then actually came on, ran out the game okay. She's in the lineup today. Money's at the line.
It's always great to see a player respond when they've been slightly down on form, like Leilani has, to come out and really take this game by the scruff of the neck and come out and try and produce some numbers.
Full court press here by the Rangers. Fire able to get into the front court. Standish works with McCauley to Steph Cumming, who just turns around, shoots. Probably wasn't on. Good rebound by Alice Kunek. And the Rangers are away. Oh, hey, works across the floor. Kunek from long range.
She has shot the ball with such confidence this season, out at that three-point line.
Averaging 16 points for the season. Another missed shot by the Fire. And Bridget Ardossi, who came to the floor after that timeout, works with O'Hay. Jumper two. Off target. McCauley is crunched by Novosel. Picks up the foul.
It's one thing that Townsville don't want to get into with Dandenong is a run-and-done type game. So if they have one pass and shot, so one-and-done, that's going to be run-and-gun for Dandenong, and they just can't afford that.
Well, it plays into Dandenong's hands. We talk about how quick they are. Townsville need to control the tempo of this match. It's another foul.
They need to execute their offense. They need to get those shuffle cuts. They need to be cutting hard, making Dandenong play some defense, force some switches.
Cully works with Steph Cumming. Oh, and it's another missed pass. So they made some errors here. The fire quickly into the front court. Here's this transition we've been talking about. Novosel offensive foul. Just pushed out of the way. Let's have another look at it, Laurie.
A good read by McCulley to anticipate that spin move.
But that's experience right there, isn't it?
Well, it is. And Novosel is so quick, so explosive. To get that charge on her is very good for McCulley.
McCulley works with Steph Cumming. Fakes and looks to push inside on Ardoss. He puts up the shot. It's no good. They've had some opportunities here. The fire. And now the Rangers. Can they make the pay? Long ball over the top. Mitchell to Kunek. Just off target under pressure. Standish grabs the rebound. Works with McCulley. Got Cumming as an outlet. Works inside. And another foul's been called.
I give full credit to Rach McCulley for that. Lelaney Mitchell was back as safety, and she had to defend Newley. And Newley was making great body position, and McCulley made that pass, and really she had nothing to do but foul.
Alison Downey checks into the game for the Rangers for Natalie Novosel. Townsville have lost 10 of the past 11 meetings against the Rangers. Their only win this time 12 months ago.
Well, it's interesting. These two teams at the end of the season were actually on the same win-loss record, and Dandenong got there with that head-to-head. But, you know, Townsville rue the fact that they lost a couple of games by 1 or 2 points and would have had the double chance of perhaps be hosting this game. But here we are at Dandenong this afternoon.
It's all on the line here. Ardoss scores level. Opening quarter action. Hope you're enjoying it all on ABC1. Mitchell thought about the three. They're going to push inside. Stripped of the ball. Nicely done again by the fire defenders. Cumming. Will have to pick up the ball herself because it missed McCulley. Should have pulled up for the two.
Oh,
see, she did it all herself.
Yeah, not having a good shooting night so far.
Here's Mitchell. Cutting inside. Offensive foul again.
Yeah, Alice Kunick was trying to hold off her player to give Lelaney Mitchell a driving lane to the basket, and the referee just deemed that a hold.
Alex Wilson checks into the game for the fire as we take another look at it.
I think Alice might have gotten away with it if she just hadn't hooked her arm around.
Five team fouls, two for the Rangers. 2:14 to play in the quarter. Standish going to go to work. Ben Newley is there. McCulley going for three. 14 points last week, and she's off to a good start here.
Well, it's not only her scoring what she's bringing to this team. She's just been, she is the leader out there.
That was sweet from Ardoss.
I thought Ardoss last week against Bendigo came in and played some really quality minutes and had a real impact when she stepped on the court.
We can see that from both sides. They've got plenty of depth on their bench. Now to bring players the caliber of me and Newley and Kayla Standish onto the floor. Alison Downey for the Rangers. Rosie Mullins as well has had a pretty good season. No problems there for Kayla Standish. Margin is three. Don't forget, next week, Bendigo will play the winner of this game in the grand final. Live coverage on ABC1. O'Hay works it inside. Downey for two. Off the iron. Good rebound by Kunick, though. They get a new 24. Mitchell looking for a big game today. Going to work with Cox. Works it around. Long range from Kunick off target. Good rebound there from McCulley. And the fire away. It's over a minute to play. She lost a handle on it. Needs to get it back outside. Wilson stripped of the ball, but the foul has been called.
That was a tough drive by Wilson in there. There was a bit of traffic. She just ducked in between.
Timeout has been called. Going to see if we can get into the Dandenong huddle. Different sort of dimension for the Townsville Fire lineup at the moment. With Susie on two fouls, they've had to switch things up a little bit earlier than what they like. We've been waved out of the Dandenong huddle. But what would Mark Wright be saying to his team right now, Laurie?
Well, I think he just wants to make sure that he refocuses them maybe perhaps on their defensive rules. That last dribble penetration by Alex Wilson wasn't exactly what they wanted. So he's probably addressing them to tighten up defensively so that they're not just trading baskets out there going into this last minute of the quarter.
So that is Mark Wright in at the huddle. Certainly, look at the early stats. So there's Chris Lucas. I might see if we can duck into his timeouts.
Just one. You got a channel. These are the gaps. We need to make sure we get to them. Active, aggressive, come up with the ball. Let's go.
So that was the tail end of the Townsville Fire huddle.
Often the coaches go into a zone out of a timeout, so it'll be interesting to see if either coach employs that tactic at this late stage of the quarter.
6-15 field goal range for Townsville. They've had plenty of opportunities, going at 40%, 38% for the Rangers at the moment. The big focus from Mark Wright this week was that field goal percentage as we go to the line.
We see Amy Clydesdale has checked into the game, replacing Mitchell, which is quite a common practice. Give Mitchell that extra minute break. I think if Wilson makes this, we'll see Townsville into a bit of a full court trap, full court pressure.
Good crowd in, plenty of Townsville fans here. The bells are out.
Yes.
Here's Clydesdale. Cox going down behind play. Dossi for two off the front of the iron. They get it back again though, the Rangers. Ohay calling the shots. Dossi sets the screen. Looking for a pass outside. It's Kunek for two. Misses short again. McCulley. Just going to control the tempo to slow things down. Standish working edge of the paint. Got to find a pass. It's Wilson again taking them on. Wow. And scoring. Nice again. Limited minutes for Alex Wilson last week. 29 WNBL games, but as we said, the rookie of the year. 10 seconds of play in the quarter. Here's Clydesdale running out of room. Works to Ardossi. Got to put up the shot. Just hurled at the basket. And it's out of play with 0.6 of a second. So McCulley's going to have a go at the Hail Mary here. Point. Shoots. Look out, camera people down the other end of the court. But what a great quarter it was for the Townsville Fire. They've taken control of this one, and at quarter time, the Fire lead 22-16 here on ABC One. Let's take a look at these stats to quarter time. And as you can see, the Fire leading 22-16. Better on the field goal percentage, getting it done on the defensive boards. The 3-1. What are the stats telling you at the moment, Laurie Chizik?
Well, both teams are taking care of the ball, and we've seen that there's been very few turnovers, so it's a high-quality game in that regard. Townsville are penetrating more. They're getting the ball inside the paint and getting themselves to the line more than the Rangers and getting some easy baskets as a result of that.
Well, the dynamics changed a bit in that opening quarter with Susie Bakovic sitting down for extended minutes. She's got two fouls. But you see there, great start for the Rangers. Oh, hey to Kunek. How many times have we said that throughout this season? But then they missed plenty of shots, the Fire, but then started to get their going in the midpoint of that opening quarter. And as you say, they're taking on the defence of the Rangers.
Well, I didn't think there was any one single player from either team that dominated that quarter. I thought there were contributors from both teams at both ends of the court. So, you know, we've got Mitchell on 5 points, Mitchell on four, Kunek on five. And likewise with Townsville, there's a spread of scores. McCulley on five, Bakovic four. Now, I think the big thing out of that quarter was her two fouls forcing her to sit.
How do you assess how they had to change things up there in their lineup? Alex Wilson, as I said, getting extended minutes. They seem to adapt okay.
Well, Well, with that shuffle offense, you can place people in different positions, and as long as you're cutting hard and understanding where the shots are coming from, you can cover for something like that. And I thought Rosie Pudlovic came in and or started and played a really good role in that first quarter. And really, the absence of Susie, it didn't show on the scoreboard.
Well, defensive pressure has been huge from the Fire. We've seen a number of offensive fouls from the Rangers. In particular, Rachel McCully able to hold her position. And you can have your say on this game at ABC. WNBL is our Twitter handle. Use the hashtag WNBL if you like as well. As we're away in this second quarter, it's Leilani Mitchell with the ball. Just bounces off McCalla Cox. Works with O'Hay. They want to get the first score. Mitchell.
Townsville have come out in a zone.
10 on the shot clock.
Matchup zone.
Here's Mitchell for two. Off target. Good rebound again, though. Pedersen did well. Another long range from the Rangers. It just doesn't come off. Another opportunity for the Fire up the floor. Michaela Cox just works around the arc. Standish. Ball inside. Standish again. No good. Rebound by Pedersen. Susie sitting down to start off this second quarter.
It's so tempting as a coach to want to put her on.
O'Hay in the corner for three. Good rebounding again. One up holding firm. Bian Newley works it to Wilson for two. Gee, she's been impressive early stages of this one.
She has. She's very strong and ran the floor extremely well on that situation.
Mitchell works with O'Hay. Bounce pass. They're just taking them on again. What's the call here? Referees looking at each other. It's an offensive foul. Goodness, we've had a few of those. And again, guess who? Rachel McCully just holding her position.
I really thought that Jenna O'Hay should have pulled up and shot that ball. She looked like she'd predetermined that she was going to pass that to the roller, and I think she was open for a shot. That's her shot. That's her bread and butter, that pull-up jump shot.
Lucky that Rachel McCully didn't pop the basketball in her face there. She was on the floor. As I said, if they win today, she will play game number 300 in a grand final next week. Wilson. Stanish works with Newley. Good minutes from her last week. Wilson for three. No good. And it's Rosie Maltz who picks up the rebound from the floor to start this second quarter. Leilani Mitchell thought about the field goal, went to Malt for three. That's off target. Field goal percentage continues to drop. Ball immediately to the front court. The Towns will make them pay. McCully, 10 on the shot.
They're quite content just to use that shot clock.
They are. Wilson going to work on O'Hay, pushed off. Here's a three. Oh, off the window. Kayla Standish. Did she call that, Laurie?
Oh, and things are going your way shooting-wise.
Here's Mitchell. No good. They're not hitting their targets. Newley again for two. No good, but a good rebound by Standish. She goes herself. She misses again. This time the Rangers, plenty of numbers under the baskets.
Well, the Rangers just look really out of sorts at the moment.
Oh, hey. It's off target. It's missed again. You're right, Laurie. Timeout might be coming here. McCully pulls up from the stripe for two. They're going to get the rebound again. They're in complete control of this match. Steph coming all on her own.
Oh, Steph has not hit anything.
Here's Mitchell. Got to get something going. Works into the corner. It's Novoselle. O'Hay fakes, then pushes inside. She's fouled.
Great decision by Jen O'Hay not to just shoot that three-point shot. They hadn't been hitting their perimeter shots. They needed a good drive to the basket. Get herself to the line, steady the ship.
Dossie and Downey checking in for the Rangers. Bankovic back out on the floor for the Fire, replacing Alex Wilson. We're at the line. It'll be Jenna O'Hay.
Downey don't just need to take a deep breath out there. I think things aren't going well, so yes, they want to push the ball. That's the way they've played all year, but sometimes you just need to assess, get a feel of the game. It's not happening for them, those quick shots. So that way, it was good to see Jenna drive it to the basket.
Going at 76% from the stripe. No problems there. Margin is 9. Full court press here, and it's worked perfectly. Turnover Susie just crashes into the signs on the court.
And Townsville should know that. Danny went into that press after a made foul shot, so they should be more prepared for that.
Noltz gets it back in. Another opportunity here for the Rangers. Trying to find a way through is Leilani Mitchell. Downey will just pull up for two. Timeouts has been called.
Chris Lucas isn't going to let the Rangers get any sort of momentum happening. He wants to put a stop to it straight away.
It's a smart timeout. The Fire leading this by seven. We're going to try and get inside the Townsville Fire huddle. Let's have a listen to Chris Lucas.
Rachel here. Okay, guards here. Okay, three men. Switch through, drag. Okay, bring it over, punch, and then back to the middle.
Yeah, we're okay.
We know what we're doing, guys. Yep. We knew what we're going to get hit with.
Anyone?
Be disciplined.
Okay.
Offensively. Okay, let's keep moving the ball. Let's look at first option here. We'll go to Kayla, go to the three spot. We're going 31. All right, let's go deep into the clock till we get a good shot, okay? Defensive glass, doing a great job. Keep that up. Let's go.
So just resetting his team, Chris Lucas, in that timeout, Laurie.
Well, he mentioned exactly what I had said about they should have known what they should to do against that press and not to let it happen again, so he just refreshed their memories, then gave them an offensive structure that he wants them to run this time down the court.
Back to it back out on the floor. Let's go to Steph Brance, who is having a listen to Mark Wright.
Yeah, very calmly talking his girls through the offense and encouraging them to really, he wants them to get to the foul line. That was his final words, and he repeated it several times.
Thanks, Steph. Good to have you back on the WNBL coverage as well. Right at the business end of the season, he's coming, working with McCulley. Susie looking to cut inside, but the outlet pass is for Cumming. Just going to drive baseline. Got to put it up. Got to put it up. She does. It's off target. It'll be a changeover anyway. Oh, Hayes off to the races. But there's three Townsville defenders in front of her. Doing well to get back. Just covering that transition, the Fire.
Right now, Danny Nong have only two of their starters on, and they're really making some inroads into this lead that Townsville have.
Mitchell, Ohay will just go herself. That is all class from Jenna Ohay. Under all sorts of pressure, cool as you like. Nailing the two. Standish to Steph Cumming. Working with McCulley. Batkovic over the top. Well done. Just not pulling it off though. Kayla Standish with the one under the basket. Good defensive pressure again by the Rangers. As Ohay works with Ardossi to Mitchell on the overlap. Now cutting inside Mitchell. The bounce pass intended for Ardossi. Bounces off hands. Mitchell had time for the three. Instead goes for the two. She's crunched. Downey for two.
Allison Downey, big time player. That is five crucial points that she's put in at this stage.
The court wipers are out on the floor. And the momentum has shifted in this game. It's a 3-point lead now to Townsville.
That's the thing with Danny Nong. They are so potent. They have so many scorers out there that even if they're nine down, it's not a good enough lead. They can explode at any stage, and we've just seen that.
And they produce huge numbers in second halves too, Laurie. The Standish working back. Mitchell slams it into Tony Caldwell, the referee. That's never a good thing to do, even when it is accidental. So Rachel McCulley sits down. What a game she's had so far.
So Danny Nong are doing a good job of mixing up their defenses right now between zone and man-to-man. And it certainly slowed down the scoring output from Townsville.
Fox works with Cumming. Standish over the top. Susie's being manhandled, double-teamed, anything you like. She misses a shot. She's under all sorts of pressure down there. She needs help out underneath. You look for the out-there pass. You get someone at the three-point line. You've got time. Ohay. Nine on the shot clock. Pushing inside. Lost a handle on it. We'll just shoot it again. You're going to have fun coaching her at the Worlds.
I tell you what, Jenna just, she thinks on her feet or thinks in the air. She seems to give herself so much time to make those decisions and with such poise.
The margin is one. Kickball. We get back to 14. Does that give you an added dimension of excitement knowing that you're going to be coaching that player on the screen right now?
Well, there's a few of them out there that actually there's six players in the Opal squad that are playing in these two teams, and it is very exciting.
Danny Nong on a 10-0 run. Cox long range, in and out. And Downey works with Mitchell. In control now, the Rangers having a good run. Mitchell to make it 12 in a row. It's no good. Backovic, solid hands. They press up again. Cox under pressure. There's the free player coming. Working with Standish. Backovic saw a bit of that last week where she just stands at the top of the arc. Coming again. She'll look to push inside. Did well in the end and it drops for her. That ends a 10-0 run in this second quarter. Mitchell works with Downey, ball over the top. O'Hare bounces off the traffic and misses short. She was looking for the foul. Looks straight to the referee.
Well, it's interesting. This game style actually suits Townsville. It's very low scoring.
Newley for two. Easy line, cut through the defense. That's far too easy for the Fire. Mitchell did well, but two, just can't finish it. Field goal percentage is at 32%. The shots just aren't dropping. Cox, did she get it? No, she was crunched though. And she'll go the line for a couple.
Jenna Hay made sure that she was not going to finish that shot. Make her earn it from the stripes.
Alice Kunick checks into the game for Jenna O'Hay. Not a bad like for like. Kayla Pedersen replaces Rosie Maltz, seeing some extended minutes in this second quarter. And Natalie Novoso will replace Leilani Mitchell. And a timeout. Why not? We've had three substitutions. Now let's have a timeout. So 2:46 to play. There's a big run from the Rangers, but still the Fire hang on to the lead, which stands at five. Well, it's a good way to stop the run, and we've just seen the defensive pressure just drop ever so slightly from the Rangers in the last minute or so.
I'm not sure whether it was a drop, maybe just a little bit of lack of focus and a recognition from Townsville that they couldn't settle just for those pull-up jump shots. That, you know, they needed to get it to the rack, which Mia Newley did beautifully.
So what's Chris Lucas going to say to his team, Laurie, this stage? Because they are still in control, even though they've been pushed in this second quarter.
Well, again, I think he would be talking about what he wants offensively, and if he wants to make any changes rule-wise. There's, again, no player that's really dominating from Danny Nong, so I think his defensive rules are fine. And if you look at the score, keeping Danny Nong to 26 points close to halftime, they'd have to be pretty happy with that.
Absolutely.
I would like to see the ball perhaps go into Susie's hands a little bit more down low, and if Danny Nong double, triple team, get her to kick it out.
Steph, what did Chris Lucas have to say?
Yeah, well, Laurie was absolutely right. You should think about coaching Laurie, perhaps. he was absolutely talking about their offenses and what roles he wanted each of them to play. And on D, he wants more of an awareness of where their shooters are.
Oh, clearly you missed a calling, Laurie.
There you go.
Multitasking.
Well, I tell you, before today's game, I was nervous, and not nervous about commentating, but I was just thinking about the coaches and what they're thinking about and what they'd be instructing their players and their shoot-arounds this morning. And finals time, there's just nothing like it.
Does look a bit refreshed, better than he ended up last week, Laurie, Chris Lucas. For the toughest game he's coached for the season. Novoselle works with Downey. Kunick pushes back. Ardossi, top of the arc. They just share around Downey. They're winding down the 24. Bounce pass. Ardossi's a free player. Needed to nail it, but didn't. Backovic with the rebounds.
That was good execution by Downey Nong and ended up in a good shot, just didn't score.
Oh, Newley needs to pick this up. She could have gone for the three, but well done by Ardossi. There's a turnover in the backcourt. Novoselle 2 minutes to play before half-time. Bounce pass, Dossie. Looking for someone coming inside. Oh, Susie did it again! Two on one, it's Michaela Cox. Oh, blocked beautifully! Alison Downey! That would have to be one of the plays of the day, Laurie, surely.
Well, that was just a bit of a comedy of errors. We had a turnover at the one end, then straight down, then Susie gets a steal at the other end, and then it didn't even result in a basket and a two-on-one.
Remember, you're on play of the day duty this afternoon, Laurie. So we're locking that one in for the moment. Kunek works around Downey. Here's long range. Kunek!
Alice Kunek has hurt Townsville in the past, and they need to get a hand. They need to make her put it on the floor.
She's up to 8 points. 90 seconds to play before halftime. Cox works with Steph Cumming. Looking to push inside, running out of room. Cox, he likes it from there. No good. Bundovic, well done. Works with McCulley. Steph Cumming steps inside for two. That'll lift her confidence.
Well, and you know what? It's great to see that she wasn't second-guessing herself. Should I, shouldn't I shoot that shot? She's a shooter. She's a scorer. We'll see what happens from here.
And she's up to 6 points for the game. Okay, works it around. Kunek thinking about it, but steps inside for the two this time. No problem at all. Margin three. McCulley works with Cox. Just feel that they've got to be in front at halftime. And Levick works it back to McCulley. Susie's travelled. I don't think too many arguments there. So 37.4 seconds here. And we'll still get two more plays at least out of this first half. Novacell works with O'Hay. Kunek again. Just hurled it at the basket that time. That was going to be no good. And here's a foul. Players all over it. Budlevic involved. Susie trying to calm things down.
Well, you know what? That is purely emotions of the game. Those two have been teammates for a long time. They would be good friends off the court.
Oh, look at that. Rosie Budlevic, look at the arm there. No wonder Alison Downey wasn't happy. Oh, she wanted to go on with it as well. There's some heat in the kitchen here. Timeout's been called meanwhile. We're going to see if we can get inside the Townsville huddle. Chris Lucas chatting with Claudia Brassard. See what they're going to set up with this final play of the half.
The one we want to give up is a skip pass.
Okay. All right, now. We're in goal, away from Susie. All right, so make that pass, when I hold the ball, go late. Even if it's man or zone, still run it. Okay, still run it. Okay, you make the pass, Rachel on the flare, step you in the corner. Okay, set the ball pit, engage the second line if it's zone. If it's man, same thing. On the air, time of the pass, Susie. Go and find the seal, we'll get to the ball. We need off the ball, don't just pop, don't go too low. Don't bring the other defender down. All right, get on the high glass.
So that was from Chris Lucas. Let's have a look at the incident before that timeout, Laurie. Let's look at it from another angle here. Just, you talk about the emotions. Budlevic. Well, there was, you just see that arm going back in.
Well, I think
Downey.
She felt that she was dragged down, so she's flung the arm, so it's been... That's okay.
Steph Woodenbach right after say.
Yeah, pretty calm, stressing the importance of each person playing their own role. And what Leilani Mitchell was repeating before they went back out in the court, rebound, rebound, rebound.
14 seconds to play in the half. Townsville lead by three. Michaela Cox, bounce pass, McCulley, seven to play. Back outside, Cox will step inside, thought about it. Got to put it up. 1 second, Susie. Here on ABC1 this afternoon. This is preliminary final basketball. And it's the Townsville Fire 34 leading the Dandenong Rangers 31. Paul, the Rangers made a run in that second quarter, but the Townsville Fire did well just to peg them back. And I'm sure the Dandenong Rangers will want to improve that field goal percentage. Jenna O'Hay has 9 points for the game so far. She's with Laurie Chiswick.
Jenna, it's been a half of real momentum swings out there. How does it feel?
It's tough out there. We always have good battles with Townsville, and it's a bit of a grind, but, you know, I'm happy with the way the girls are playing, and we just need to keep getting defensive stops.
This is the sort of game that suits Townsville, where there is a grind. Do you think in the second half you'll try and get out and break out a little bit more in some transition game?
Yeah, that's where we play our best basketball. We haven't been able to get many transition buckets, and, you know, that's when we're best, when we've got a lot of energy, and, yeah, we need to really lift our intensity in the second half.
There was one stage where you got, I think, 3 baskets in a row, just willing your team to follow with you. You've had 9 points in this first half. Jenna, how are you feeling out there? Are you tired? Is it physical?
Yeah, it's really, really physical. You know, it's do or die. You got to leave everything out there. That's what I'm trying to do.
Good luck the second half. We have here Laurie Chiswick, a 3-point ball game in at the halftime break, and what a quarter that was. There was, the field goal percentage took an absolute hammering early on. It took quite some time for anyone to hit a shot.
Well, I tell you what, it went for a phase in that quarter where just it was comedy of errors, people missing their shots out there. And we can see by the shooting percentages that they're not as high as we'd usually expect in something like a final like this. I'm not sure whether it's nerves. Everything is on the line out there. They both know they're playing for a grand final spot.
Let's take a look at the Dandenong Rangers. And we know what a talent Jenna O'Hay is. Alex Koenig from outside the D. She's been absolutely incredible.
Well, Alice Koenig has hit some big threes out there. Then when you close out long to her and she steps around and does another 2-point shot, she's really deadly, and they'll need to take care of that.
And much bigger spread of scorers for the Townsville Fire.
Well, Susie didn't really have an impact that quarter, and we can see that she's got only the 4 points now. That's going to be hard to hold her down in the second half, but Dandenong, to their credit, are doing great, great, great job on their superstar.
Well, let's have a look at some of the big moments from the second quarter. It was really a case of swinging momentum. Laurie, I know you're having trouble hearing me because it is so loud in this stadium.
Well, like I said, that quarter was a bit of a grind out there, and there weren't many easy baskets. Both teams had to work the ball through hands, had to really work for their shots. Defense seemed to crank it up a little bit. There weren't a lot of second chance opportunities, and both teams, like I said, the momentum swung. However, Jenna O'Hay at one stage of that game, I think where they were down by 9 points, took it upon herself to just lead that team and bring them back within reach.
Well, you mentioned Jenna. She is just such an important presence for the Dandenong Rangers. We're going to have a look at her in just a moment, but Townsville Fire, Susie Bakovic back on the court. That would have been a temptation, as you said, too hard to resist.
Yeah. Well, it's okay to have 2 fouls in that second quarter. If she had got her third, she would have had to rest. But again, I think Danny and I are doing a good job on her. Whether the ball goes inside to her and they double, triple team and she's got to kick it back out and then be in there for the rebound, I'm just not sure they've used her that effectively.
The challenge though for Townsville Fire, Laurie, is how do you stop Jenna O'Hay?
Well, that's a good question. It's you pick any player on the teams and how do you stop somebody like Jenna, because she can score herself very, very effectively. But the other thing Jenna is great at is assists. So while you can take care of business with her, she's going to find that open player. She's a very good decision maker. She's got a great basketball IQ. And she is such a competitor. She plays with so much poise out there. And if it's down the stretch, if it's tight, you're going to see the ball in Jenna O'Hay's hands.
Yeah, certainly will, and she'll undoubtedly be a very valuable part of this second half. Jenna O'Hay, what an absolute talent. You look forward to having her in the Opal side come the rest of the year. She'll likely also, we'll talk about her in the All-Star 5, and 3 of the players in that All-Star 5 we're seeing on the court today. Let's start with the point guard position and have a look at Leilani Mitchell. We've really admired what she's done throughout the season, and we've talking about her being a replacement for the retiring Christy Harrower.
Well, Leilani was really unknown to the league, and she just burst onto the scene and had great numbers and really caught everybody's attention. She can score herself. She can create for others. She can be really disruptive on defense. And with that, she's been credited with her first All-Star 5 in the WNBL, and how fantastic. And a look in, as you mentioned, as an Opal squad member.
Indeed, and what's fascinating about Leilani is, given her height, as you would expect of a point guard, she's inside, she's up and under, she puts them up from outside, she's all over the place. And of course, she's got some really able support there in Jenna, who we've spoken about. She's just such a talent and such a team player.
Well, again, with Jenna, what do you say? She's, you know, she's been in the All-Star 5 a few times. She just leads her team. If they need a score, she's the one to do it. She will take her teammates, say, climb on my back and I will get this done. I will take you across the finish line. She's got such a way to score, too. She uses her body really well. She's very strong. And like I said, such a fierce competitor. She wants to win.
Yeah, she certainly does. How about Laura Hodges, Adelaide Lightning? She's another one. Every time she's on the court, she's a presence and always makes an impact.
Well, the thing I like about Laura Hodges is I think out of all our five All-Star 5, she's had the most consistent year, right from game one right through to the end. She was Adelaide's go-to player. That was her role this year. She increased her range to go along with her running the floor, finishing inside. And she had career best numbers and has been rewarded with her very first All-Star 5. Fantastic for Hodges.
Yeah, great to see her there. Now, Susie Badridge in the middle here today for the Townsville Fire, the reigning MVP. She's such a valuable part of any side, and it's been great to see her really have an impact with this Townsville team.
Well, she started the season a little bit slow. We weren't sure whether she was injured or, and then she just worked herself into it and now is in MVP contention. And the way with Susie is she's just so unconventional. She just finds ways and means to score. You think you've stopped her, you think you've got a grasp on her. We know, everybody in the world knows she goes left and loves to go left, but it's still very hard to stop her. Second in rebounding and leads the league in scoring.
Well, and how about the other, if we're talking about bigs and how important they are inside, how strong and how difficult to stop, we're going to see Gabe Richards next week, and she's had a fantastic season.
Well, she has, and her numbers scoring-wise are slightly down from last season, but she is still regarded as the premier player inside that uses her body so well to post up, to seal, to get those offensive rebounds. She is such a team player. She is so hard to stop and very, very deserving of an All-Star 5.
Well, and you're likely to see many of them in the Opals camp, Laurie. Do tell us, though, put yourself in the coaching position, which I think you've been half there for the first half of this match. What's being said in the dressing rooms?
Well, as Jenna alluded to, I think Danny Nong, this is playing into Townsville's hands. Danny Nong want to get out and run, so they need to get that block out, get that rebound, and push the ball. For them, it doesn't have to be in Mitchell's hands. Kunit can run the ball. O'Hay, we know, can push it. And Novosel is a great handler. So they want to get those easy transition baskets. For Townsville, they want to continue to stick to their defensive structure, how they're guarding people. They need to contain Alice Kunit, who's very hard. I was saying get out and carry a hand, and then she just does a one dribble pull up around. So, you know, both coaches would be going over their defensive rules and what they want to bring this second half.
Well, both sides have had a turn at the run of play. Who do you think momentum is with going into this second half?
Well, I'd have to say Danny Nong, only because Townsville had that lead and Danny Nong chipped away at it. And I thought they just looked a little bit more poised at the end of that half. But really, Steph, that's splitting hairs. There's not a lot in it right now.
Well, we can't wait to see this second half here at the Danny Nong Basketball Stadium. It's a 3-point ball game at halftime. We'll be back with the second half right after this.
Starting Friday's ABC One's exclusive coverage of the 2014 Paralympic Games from Sochi. Our coverage starts in the early hours of Saturday morning with the opening ceremony live, and then continues for the 10-day festival of elite sport. Check out ABC One or live streaming through ABC Grandstand online. Yeah, very much looking forward to the Winter Paralympics, and that's where Darren Boyd is winging his way to right now. And Amanda Shalala will bring you all the action from over there. Don't forget, you can actually live stream throughout the event on the ABC Grandstand website. Halftime here at the Danny Nong Basketball Stadium. The Townsville 5-34, leading the Danny Nong Rangers 31. Here's Laurie Chizik has rejoined me in the commentary position. We talk about the second half, and we've seen in the three meetings that Townsville had against the Rangers that Townsville have tended to fade and the Raiders have lifted. But there's been reasons for that. Often when, in fact, at the times that they've played down here in Melbourne, the Fire have come off a road double, so they've already played a game before they come up against the Rangers. They play a high-intensity game. You expect that level to drop off slightly. And the match that they played in Townsville, they actually had a Wednesday game before the Saturday game. So they've had multiple matches each week that before they get to the Dandenong Rangers.
Well, that plus the last time they played them, Peter, Rachel McCauley went down in the first quarter with a suspected broken cheekbone and didn't play for the whole game. So, and they just played Melbourne the night before, so that certainly I think played into the factor of that last game. But tell you what, Dandenong would know that they faded last week and not want that to happen, and Townsville equally would know that they got out of a tight situation last week and showed that poise.
So the team's just getting their final instructions. Don't forget, next week, live coverage on ABC1, the 2013-14 WNBL Grand Final will be live from Bendigo, the winner of this game, to play the Bendigo Spirit. We're heading up the highway again, second consecutive year. Mark Wright, final messages.
Well, I tell you what, Townsville would desperately like to repeat last year and get up and have another chance at Bendigo, and equally Dandenong would like to make amends for last week's loss and have another shot.
Well, the impressive thing with the Fire last week was they were pushed by the Boomers. The Boomers would get in front, but then Townsville just had that knack of just ever so slightly just wrestling back the momentum when they were down to get themselves into that winning position.
And that's really important, having won a game like that, to be able to finish a game off when it's really close, because that can hold you in good stead and you can have that belief that you're going to win that game.
But time after time, we've seen this Dandenong Rangers lineup dominate third quarters. Just put the foot down. They were talking with Steph about Jenner O'Hay, but Alice Kunick up to 10 points for the game. What a season she's having. Wait for the Fire to arrive back on the floor.
One thing I think is interesting, Peter, if you look at all the shoulders, knees, the tape that you see in a grand final series compared to the start of the year,
Yeah. Everybody's
just being held together.
Away we go. The Fire lead. Third quarter action live on ABC1. It's coming. Just looking to put the ball over the top. Back of it from the strike for two. Misses. It'll go back to Steph coming with a new 24.
Just setting up their shuffle offense.
Cox works with Newley. Coming. Works it across to Cox. Bounce pass to Bakovic, 10 on the shot. Looking to push inside. That's heavy work. Just couldn't come up with a basket. Looking for the foul as well.
Did a good job of taking away her left.
Novosel, Mitchell, O'Hay in the corner. She'll just go for three.
Why not? Great read on that on-ball screen where her defender was. Gave her time to have a look at the basket. Never in doubt.
These are crucial minutes for the Townsville Fire. Scores level. Coming works it inside. McCulley off the window. It's no good again. Is it McCulley? Stole it. Stole it. Mitchell. Cox. Back outside. Yuli will step inside for two. Well done, Fire.
That was a great job by Rachel McCauley. She posted up Mitchell, looked for the ISO, didn't make that basket, but the second effort came up with a steal.
Yep, that's when Mitchell wasn't suspecting. 10 on the shot, but Jenna goes inside of the window. She is going to drag them into this grand final if she can. O'Hay is up to 14 points. McCauley works with Cox. Oh, nice little give and go from Susie. Cox just couldn't complete. And I think Jenna O'Hay is down. She popped one. She's still in back play. And now she'll make her way back up. She doesn't look good, Laurie, at the moment. Kunick foul on Rachel McCauley. Well, let's go back to Jenna O'Hay for a moment. She took a long time to get up and then just very slowly made her way up the floor.
Not sure if she just got winded there.
have another look. She just crashed to the floor. She's still not 100%, but still out there. Retain possession though. The Rangers foul. Reaching around.
Just that quick little change of pace by Novosel.
Kayla Cox picking up her first personal foul. There's another shot of Jenna O'Hay down the other end of the floor. 14 on the shot here. And two team fouls going the way of the fire. Kunek through some heavy traffic for two. No good. This will be an interesting contest, Cox. Just cool as you like. Kane through. She picks it up again from McCulley. Batkovic will go and work with Steph Cumming with McCulley. 10 on the shot clock now. Mitchell. McCulley just stepped around her and made two. Oh, that is experience. Game going up a gear. It's Townsville by two. Hope you're enjoying all the action on ABC1. Dip through traffic. Nicely done again by the fire. A finger-tipper from Steph Cumming.
That was a good leap by Steph Cumming, because Alice Kunick was going to score if she got that where she was positioned.
Kick ball here. So we'll take it. The fire will take it from the side. Cumming works with McCulley. Newly. He's going to be the cutter inside here. Kayla Cox thinking about driving baseline. Finds her way through. Just can't finish.
Good defense by Novosel.
Yeah, but they're setting it up nicely, the fire. But here are the Rangers with the response. Mitchell, O'Hay, into the paint. Oh, that could almost have been a play of the day. If that had a drop, this is dangerous. Cox did well, though. Great poise to get it to Cumming. Could see the traffic going straight at her. And McCulley works it across again to Cox. Ball inside. Batkovic for two. It hung there for a while. It's off hands. It'll be a Rangers ball. Defensive baseline.
Well, both teams are finding it extremely difficult to get baskets right now. And I must say I'm impressed, though, with Dandenong, how they're actually executing. They're not just, you know, passing it once and shooting it up. They're getting through some stuff and...
Both sides are. They just can't finish it off. Here's O'Hay. Kunek through traffic. Lots of handle on it. Batkovic was there. Working with McCulley. Cox for three. Oh, Batkovic the put back. Oh, no good. She's got it again, though. How long has she been in there? She goes off the window for the two. And that's what we've been saying for the last couple of weeks about Susie Batkovic. Doesn't matter how many you put on her. She always finds a way. Mitchell pulls up for the two. It's no good. Batkovic on the deck. Working hard, Newley. Cox in the free player. Three on two. Which way will she go? Into the corner. Oh, yes. Steph Cumming.
Good timeout by Mark Wright again. Let's stop that momentum by Townsville, which they have.
Had to call it. It's a four-point ball game. 5:42 to play in this third quarter. Preliminary final action on ABC1. We're not going to get inside the Dandenong huddle, understandably slow. So Mark Wright will not be happy, Laurie Chizik.
Well, I'm not sure that he wouldn't be happy. I mean, that was a great shot by Steph. I suppose it's that fast break situation that he wants to stop. He needs to make sure that they're grinding it out as well. If they're not going to get transition baskets, he certainly doesn't want Townsville to.
I know he's in full-on game mode at the moment, but anything as a coach in the back of your mind about previous results, about last year, does that enter your thinking at any stage during this match?
Although I must say, when Michaela Cox shot that ball, I was thinking about last year, how she just lit it up in the corner where Steph Cumming just made that shot, and she just was on fire.
That's the fire huddle breaking up. Chris Lucas just keeping things calm. Let's take a look at some of the highlights already in this third quarter. There's Batkovic on the deck. Great work. And he was a three on two, Laurie. Went into the corner. Steph Cumming on the line. Bang. 8 points for Steph Cumming. Leading the scorers for Townsville. Jenna O'Hay has 14 for Dandenong. Alice Kunek with 10. Novosel. Working with Ardossi, back to Mitchell. 10 on the shot here for Jenna O'Hay. Going to work on Steph Cumming. Just in the corner, foul. Wanted to go high off the window. As Alistair Downey checks into the game. Steph Brands, you were having a listen to the Townsville huddle.
I sure was. Chris Lucas was pretty happy with how his ladies are going on D. He was a bit concerned they're getting too bogged down in the one-on-one play.
Been very busy, our Stephanie Brands. W League, golf, Australia Day festivities, everything. You can do it all.
Multi-talented.
Absolutely.
Here's this press after a foul shot.
Margin is four. Cumming will just wait for the cavalry. 5:17 to play in the third quarter. The preliminary final. The loser is eliminated. Cumming has been given some latitude. Works to Newley for two. That was sweet.
Just in the middle of the zone there. Nobody defending that shot over a hand.
It's important for the Fire. There's 6 points. We've seen Dandenong respond time and time again. O'Hay just does that. That's how they respond.
The thing is Jen O'Hay is taking advantage of the fact that she's taller than Steph Cumming, that she can just shoot over her, even though Steph has good position.
Backovic working low post, picks it back out. Cumming works it around. McCulley's all on her own. Oh, it didn't drop. What a golden opportunity here. But again, Mitchell. Michaela Cox just came in over the top and got the foul. That is her second. It is 14 fouls for Townsville, none for Dandenong in this quarter.
What about the desperation of both teams? Yep. Diving on loose balls, just trying to come up with it, saving it for their team.
But this is what playoffs basketball is all about. Seen some cracking matches. Still got one to go. O'Hay, 14 on the shot. Oh, across there to Alani Mitchell. The through hands will be retained by the Rangers with 10. So O'Hay to work it over the top to Mitchell. Kunick creates some space with 7 on the shot clock. Time is running down. They're just going to ice it down. Mitchell's going to be the player to take them all on. Oh, did want to get around Susie, and what a finish! Contender for player of the day.
I think that would go down.
Oh, over the top, Bob Newley.
Rachel McCauley, you are having the game of your life.
7 points. More importantly, getting it done at both ends of the floor. Here's Mitchell again, taking them all on again. Flicking it back out. Drops for Downey.
What a great read by Allison Downey on Lainey Mitchell's drive. She's cut hard to the basket so that when she was stopped, she had somebody to pass it to. It was almost looked like a little bit of a surprise.
So, Allison Downey, the and one. Didn't drop. Backovic works with Cumming. Works into the corner for McCulley. Standish and Backovic. 10 on the shot clock. McCulley through her hands. It's okay though. Newley's there. Got to get through the traffic. Standish had to power away. 4 seconds. They turned it over. It's 3-on-1 though. And O'Hay's in the minority. Ball across. Oh, Mitchell for three. Good hands by Backovic. Tapped out of her hands too. It'll be a fireball in the backcourt. Let's go sideline, where Steph Brands is standing by with a very interesting coach, the coach of the Bendigo Spirit, Bernie Harawa.
I think he's a spectator watching this match the closest out of everybody. Bernie Harawa, welcome, and first of all, congratulations on the Spirit being back in the grand final, the hosting position. This is a familiar experience for you, being at the prelim final. Tell me, have you identified yet who you'd least like to play?
No, not really. Look, they're both very good teams, and they both bring their own things that are difficult to defend, and at the end of the day, which the team that you get will be the team that's the best of the two.
We've got a turnover in the middle of the floor here. We'll come back to you in a moment, Bernie. Here's Mitchell to Kunec. Off target. They've got it again. There's a foul. A foul on Ardossi.
Oh. Bernie, now that there's a slight break in action, do you watch this game really clinically sitting here, or do you just watch it and sit back and enjoy the atmosphere if you can?
Yeah, a little bit of both. You have a look at what they're doing and what they do after foul shots and timeouts and things like that, but generally you we'll go home and analyse it more on the tape than what we get out of it today.
And Bernie, all your players healthy after last week's game?
Yeah, everybody's come up pretty good. We had an Endicott practice game yesterday, and that went well for us.
Bernie, on what you're seeing right now, who's going to win the game?
Look, I think it's neck and neck. I just think at the moment, Dandenong seem to have a little bit of momentum, and it's just going to... I think it'll come down to who can make the big shots at crunch time, and that's hard to know who that's going to be right now. I just sense that Dandenong have lifted a little bit here.
Well, you can enjoy watching these sides tie themselves out ahead of next week. Good luck next week in the grand final. Thanks for joining us.
Thanks for that.
Bernie Harrower, the Bendigo Spirit coach down there sideline with Steph Brands. But a couple of passages of play there, and you look at the scoreline, it has not moved.
Oh, there are bodies flying everywhere, and I think the pressure's building. Some players are missing some uncharacteristically, you know, close shots that normally they'd make.
See, that's the thing. We sit here in commentary, and when you see the bodies just flying around, you've got a broad smile on your face, because then you put your coaching hat on. That's what you want to see. They're not leaving anything. They're giving it all. Scores level again. 1:54 to play in this third quarter. Batkovic works with Wilson. Seeing some minutes in this third quarter. Cumming works with McCulley. Batkovic. Nice cut inside. Gee, that's good from Wilson. That is why she's the Rookie of the Year.
Way too easy. Just no vision on the back of that zone.
Ohay, ball inside, back out again. That's a nice weave, but they work it to Downey off target. Kunec has it slapped out of her hands by Batkovic. Another opportunity here for the Fire. McCulley. Steph Cumming was just held up. Working it around, Steph Cumming. Former Dandenong player. Wilson with 8 on the shot clock, looking for Susie. It's deep, it's a foul. Now, who's going to pick out the foul? Natalie Novosel, the unlucky player. That's her third personal foul, Laurie.
Just as a coach, you want players moving on the flight of the ball. And when that ball left Wilson's fingertips on the way to Susie Batkovic, 3 Dandenong Rangers players were just collapsing.
Rachel McCulley sitting down for the last minute 7 of this third quarter. Michaela Cox out onto the floor. So the shot clock, of course, at 14. Coming over the top, works with Standish. Spin move for 2.
Wow, that was tough. She was fading away. She had a hand in her face.
It is clutch right there. Margin is 4. Kunec. Looking to get around Batkovic. In the corner, Novosel flicks it back out. Downey works with Ohay. 10 on the shot clock. Under a minute remaining in this third quarter. It's Novosel for 3. It's too big. They'll get it back again. Ohay with 2 seconds. That one came off the iron. 35 seconds remaining.
Good recognition by Ohay that the clock hadn't been reset. She just needed to get another one up.
That would have lifted the crowd. Carla Cox with her hands on it. Back to it. Just blocks out Kunec. Driving inside is Wilson. Not afraid to take them on, and she draws the foul.
She's so strong, Wilson, that she can really absorb that bump out there and get a relatively good shot up.
17.5 seconds remain. It'll be the final possession going to the Rangers. Marcel sits down. Mitchell checks back in.
Be interested to see if Mitchell just holds on to the ball for this last play and really uses and works an on-ball screen, or if they get the ball in Jen O'Hay's hands.
Oh, missed again, but Standish puts it back in. win. Oh, they relax just that little bit there. The Rangers, there's 12 seconds remaining. Margin is 6. Kunick waits in the corner. Mitchell going left side. Downey for 2. Got it! That is an important basket for the Dandenong Rangers. We've got 1 quarter to play in the preliminary final. And the Fire still in front. They lead it 52-48 here on ABC One. Let's have a look at the stats at three-quarter time, Laurie Chiswick, and we can see a four-point lead to the Townsville Fire. Slightly better on the field goal percentage. The Rangers putting up just slightly more three-pointers. You can see the rebound count. They're winning that at the moment, the Fire, and getting it done on the O boards as well.
Well, really, that game, or that quarter was very equal. Townsville ended up winning it by 1 point, but seriously, there was not a lot in it.
As we look at the highlights to three-quarter time, and still, Townsville with their noses in front. They outscored the Rangers by 1 in that quarter, and they were pushed hard again, but they just come up with the big plays at the right time.
Well, the thing for Townsville is, you know, Susie had 2 points that quarter. She's got 6 for the game so far. And so they're doing it without their big scorer. You know, they're sharing it around out there. Newley's got 10. She's come up with some big baskets. They push the ball. Steph Cumming, that big three from the corner. And for Dandenong, well, Jen O'Hay led them, I thought, that quarter.
9 points for her in that third quarter. She's up to 18, leading all scorers at the moment. Alice Kunek has 12. Which way is it going to go in this final quarter, Laurie?
Well, I think if it... Again, for Dandenong, I think they want to get some transition baskets. They're more comfortable in that running type game. However, I've been really impressed in how they've controlled themselves in the quarter court. Oh, I don't know. It is too hard to call, but I tell you what, both teams, there will be nothing left. They will throw everything they've got out there. This is a quality, quality game.
Played in round 3, the margin was 3 points. Dandenong getting the win that occasion. Since there's been 15 points and 20 points. All Dandenong's way. Here we go. Final quarter, the preliminary final. Hope you're enjoying the action on ABC One. Oh, hey, early start 2.
Townsville going to have to address that, and I'm not really sure how. You can't really double her because whoever you leave open is so potent as well. But she's hurting them just on that screen.
Kelly works with Steph Cumming. Thought about the 3, then stood inside for the 2. Got it! We saw last week some amazing shooting, particularly from that Townsville-Melbourne game. We got a foul. If I pick up what that foul was for, it was happening in the backcourt.
I didn't even... who was it on? Susie?
No. She got to 3. She's done well to keep her foul count down, by the way. So she expects extended minutes in this final quarter. Kunick for 3!
You see,
you shut down one, the other one stepped up.
Her hand was there. You've got to get closer. Alice does not need any space.
Margin is 1. Michaela Cox to Standish. 10 on the shot clock. Crowd getting involved. Cumming, thinking about driving baseline, puts a bounce pass in. Standish over 2.
Well, maybe we'll just go basket for basket this quarter.
I don't know if I could go another close game, Laurie. Particularly after the brilliance of last week. Here's O'Hay. Pass it back out. Ardossi fumbled. Then get the friendly roll. No. There's Kunek again. Great rebound. That comes up with the ball.
Smart play to knock it off McCulley's foot. She had nowhere to go with the dribble.
What a season Alice Kunek's having, averaging 16 points a game. Been a breakout season for her. Lelani Mitchell too slick for O'Hay. The ball makes its way out of play. Another turnover.
Both teams have really taken care of the ball well this game. 6 turnovers, 8 turnovers for Townsville.
Cully. What a game she's having. Oh, Chizik has identified. Coming in the corner for 2. It's off target. Batkovic, though, off the window. Just said, Kudin, get out of the way.
She just looked down at her.
She's got that look. Yep, looks straight down at Alice Koenig. So we're down this end of the floor on the boss. Margin is 5. We've seen Danny Nong, though. Double up bigger margins than this. Koenig put her head up, fakes, pushed through. Ardossi's fouled by McCulley. Rachel McCulley has her 3rd personal foul. It's a 2nd team foul for the Fire. Oh, hey. Just pushing in on Batkovic. Makes it 2! She'll go to the line for the add one!
That is so tough. How do you defend Jenna when she's doing that?
Susie Batkovic has foul number 3.
Jenna's eyes were never off the target that whole time.
22 points, make that 23 for Jenna O'Hare.
And here's
this afternoon.
Press. Here's the press after the foul shot.
The margin is back to 2. Steph Cumming is just pushed out of the way by Alice Koenig. Referee looking straight at it, no call. Cox. Bounce pass to McCulley. 7 on the shot clock. They'll need to get a shot up in any second. 3 seconds. McCulley's just going to have to shoot. Got to shoot, Rachel. Offensive foul!
So it's really important right now that Townsville don't get rattled by any calls that are made.
What's your decision there, Laurie?
Well, not sure she was completely set on that.
Just looked to be that movement, just slightly, 1 foot down. 14 fouls for the Fire. That could be costly because the Rangers have none. 7:13 to play in the last. Oh, hey, for 3, offensive foul. Offensive foul. Bridget Ardossi is called for that foul, and that is her 4th personal. I don't think we quite caught that on the replay.
Well, yeah,
it seemed to be a tangle with
She just lifted her arms up a little bit on that screen when she was headhunting.
Steph Cumming with her hands on the ball. Under. Bridget Ardossi has 4 fouls. Batkovic 10 on the shot clock. This is great pressure for the Rangers. It's 2-on-1. Mitchell to take them on!
Feet.
Have a look at this.
Great steal.
Just 2-on-1. Michaela Cox assessed with the foul. That's her 3rd personal, 5th team foul for the Fire. But can she finish it off, Leilani Mitchell?
Well, you'd have to say the momentum is well and truly with Danny Nong right now.
Full court press 2. Cox is in all sorts of trouble. Works with Newley into the corner. Standish got a bit of time. 14 on the shot clock. Michaela Cox works it back. Newley took it to push inside for 2. Front of the iron. Rebound again by Mitchell. But here comes Steph Cumming. And it is a fireball.
That press has done a great job because it's just chipping away so much of the shot clock.
Timeout called by Townsville. The margin is 1. We're going to see if we can get inside the Townsville huddle. That is, well, would be the jump ball. I'm not going to editorialise on the arrow system, Laurie. We just don't have time for that.
Not at all.
6:26 to play as we wait for the coaching staff.
There is still so much time left in this game.
Here's Chris Lucas.
Yeah, like, just get a bit ball pit. I just run a fist option, we're fine. All right, don't be passing the ball off with 4 seconds to go expecting someone else to make a play. All right, make a play. Get on the rim. All right, offensively, let's go with one off the end line here. Okay? All right, this has got to be aggressive. All right, we're going 2 of 3. 1-3-1. We've got to know where the shooters are. Mia, go to the top, all right? Got to know where the shooters are.
So that is Chris Lucas. Let's go straight over to Steph Francis with the singer Mark Wrights.
Yeah, he was encouraging his players to keep rotating on their offense and make sure they find the gaps. He's warned Jenna O'Hay that they're probably going to have something special in mind for her as well.
The analysis from the Opals assistant coach, Laurie Chizik.
Well, I'll be interested. I think Townsville are going to go into a zone just to try and mix things up a little bit, see if they can. Often if you can, you know, force a shot, get a good rebound, you can run off of the zone.
Standish long range. No good. Oh, Susie again!
Well, our two all-star five players in Jen O'Hay and Susie Bakovic are really leading their teams right now.
So O'Hay will just spin for two. Almost. Over the top.
That's her,
it's a foul. And Bridget Ardossi will be out of the game. Yep, she just says for it. She sits down. Bridget Ardossi with 2 points.
Well, 2 points.
6 rebounds.
But I think she's played a great role in this game today. She's come out with physicality, energy. She's done what she's needed to do. She's bumped everybody that's come within her side. She's been great.
Well, as always, about the 6 minute mark of the final quarter, when it's close, I throw out the OT cards.
You do.
Are you jumping on board?
I'd love it to be overtime.
Steph?
Why not? Let's have an overtime.
Rightio. Good. About time I got some unanimous support on that. Been waiting all season. Bakovic works with Standish. McCulley. 5:42 to play. Bakovic back outside. Here it is again. Just couldn't nail it. Steph Cumming. It's off hands. It's a Ranger ball. Oh. Hope you're enjoying the action on ABC One. And remember, we've still got another game to go. The grand final next week.
Here's the 1-3-1 zone.
Inside for Kunik. Off the window.
That's what they got right now. They're running off of it.
Here goes McCulley, Newley, Stanish, Bakovic. Bakovic. She's a star.
That's exactly what they wanted out of that zone. A good rebound. Push the ball up the floor. Good position by Susie.
Up to 12 points. Oh, hey. Works it around Mitchell. She's got space for three.
Space and time. They were trying to get through that screen. They couldn't. Just left her wide open.
Scores level at Dandenong. Oh, a bit of push and shove inside the paint as well. Standish works with McCulley. Going all the way. Block shot. Foul. Jenna O'Hay again with the stomping roll. What speed. What a burst of speed from Rachel McCulley just to cut through.
Well, again, I think she just saw the bodies parting and a driving lane open up, and she just exploded out.
Jenna with 2 personal fouls. It's a third team foul on the Rangers. Again, Rachel McCulley at the line. Eight points for the game. That's her average, 14 points last week. Great role in the match against Melbourne. Townsville lead by 2. 4:31 to play in this preliminary final. What a standard of basketball. 12 seconds for Jenna O'Hay. Will she just go for 3? No good. Bakovic the rebound. Just shoves Downey out of the way. McCulley driving left-hand side. Going to slow things down. Mia Newley. McCulley over the top, back
who's
to the
open,
edge of the paint.
Open?
Now Standish coming with 8 seconds. Got it!
That was really good ball movement, making that extra pass.
And winding it down. Oh, hey. Kunec drives baseline. She is out of play. Timeout has been called by Mark Wright.
Good timeout.
Margin is four.
Stem that flow, get the momentum swinging back their way.
All right, so the lead is 4 points for Townsville. They've just kept their noses in front again, but Laurie, what's Mark Wright saying to his team? How do they set up structurally?
Well, I think they have to think about that doubling with Susie, which I think is a good idea. But they're now, Susie's done a good job twice of kicking it out of that trap and Townsville making that extra pass. So they need to be really switched on with their rotations. Offensively, I think they've sort of stopped moving. So right now, they're relying more on their one-on-one moves. I liked it when they got it through hands, made the defense shift a little bit. That zone's working, though, for Townsville.
It certainly is. 23 points for Jenna O'Hay, 15 points for Alice Kunec, and Leilani Mitchell. Good return to form for her. She's got 12.
What a big-time three that was, the last shot she made.
Four assists. When she has five-plus assists, Danny Nong tend to win more than they lose. Important factor, stretch. Steph, you haven't listened to Chris Lucas?
Yeah, just reminding his girls about execution. It's very important at this point of such a crucial match.
3:48 to play. Big crowd in Dandenong. We're off to Bendigo next week. McCulley works with Steph coming. Next score, they've got plenty of breathing space. Just worried out of again, Susie. Did well to pick it up, should just go from field goal range. It's off target, it's off hands. And fortuitously, with 4 seconds, it'll be a fireball. Should that not be a shot clock reset? Did that not hit the rim?
I'm not sure that it hit the rim. I'm not sure that's really the shot that they wanted.
Interesting. So 4 seconds for me and Yuli. Foul. Foul. And I think that foul is going to be on Kayla Pedersen.
That play, and I wish we had Bernie on mic right now, because that's a play that Bendigo used to such success with Gabe Richards down there and a shooter coming out. So how do you defend that? And that was a great lob pass into Susie.
Pedersen's third personal, fourth team foul now for the Rangers. So now the bonus, McCulley, yes.
That is all class by Rachel McCulley.
Margin is 6. 3:17 to play in the game. Rangers under all sorts of pressure now. Mitchell for 2. Oh, in and out.
That's where she scored last time.
And again for 3.
There you go. It was only a 2 that missed, so you decided I'll take the 3.
Margin is 3. McCulley, they want to stop here, the Rangers. Newley works with Batkovic. McCulley just trying to get past O'Hay, can't do so, it turned it over. Notice working back, Downey with Mitchell in the corner, waits for the traffic, Kunec off target, but they get it back, put back O'Hay. Back to a 1-point ball game. McCulley with Standish coming again. Does well. She's fouled. That foul is on, who was that called on? Was that Jenna O'Hay? Yep, there it is, the hand going in. That is her third personal.
Steph's grabbing her knee. Hope it's okay.
Both sides now. Bonus. 2:14 to play.
You still thinking overtime?
Yeah. I think Steph's still going with OT as well. Presenting a united front here. Missed the seconds. Margin is only 2. 2 minutes to play. Lenani Mitchell gets through the traffic. McCulley went down. Oh, hey! Foul! Well, and I think that's a foul on Susie.
I almost thought that Jenna could have gotten called for a foul against Rachel McCulley.
Fourth personal foul on Susie Bankovic. 2 minutes to play.
This could tie it up, and then we'll see the zone, the pressure from the press again, full court press.
Townsville hasn't won a game this season when the opposition has scored more than 74 points. Scores level at Dandenong. Two to play. They press up as they've done all game. Steph coming with it. Batkovic. Leaves it for McCulley. What an atmosphere. Newley, ball inside, tapped out by Pedersen. Five ball, seven on the shot clock.
Good look, good defense.
Seven seconds. Newley, McCulley stuck in the corner. He's going to go himself anyway and put up the shot. It's no good. Kunek gets through the traffic. They've got a chance to hit the front with 90 seconds to play. What a game. Mitchell. Oh, hey, with Kunek on the overlap. Mitchell's the free player. Kunek goes to her with six. Pushing in on McCulley. She'll go all the way. No good. Pedersen stripped of the ball. Changeover. They ran out of time.
Wow. That was a massive stop for Townsville.
Timeout has been called by Townsville. 1 minute 12 to play in the preliminary final. And scores a level. We're going to see whether we can get inside the Townsville huddle. Eddie Broussard amongst the coaching staff for the Fire. We've been waved away, understandably so. It's still anyone's game.
Well, it's anybody's game, and the crowd are into this. I hope all our fans, I'm sure all the Bendigo girls are sitting back loving this action, not knowing who they're going to play until we have a minute 12 to go in this game.
Steph, you're in the first ball screen. All right, we're having a look at the two-man there. We don't get it. Change side slide to low post and wait. We'll get you on a cross bit. Be available on the perimeter, okay? If it gets broken down, we're in fist. Rachel, you must get the ball in your hands. Penetration on the rim. All right, let's go.
The instructions there from Chris Lucas, the coach of the Townsville Fire. Steph, which huddle were you engaged with there?
I was loitering on the very outskirts of Chris Lucas's huddle because I don't think he wanted anyone in there, but he was just talking the girls through what he wants them to do on offense, what their options are, and this one starting with Steph coming off the screen. If that doesn't work, then they'll go to the high and low post, but he wants the ball in Rachel McCulley's hands.
1 minute 12 remaining in the preliminary final. Scores a level. Fire with possession.
This is everything on the line. This is for a spot in the grand final against Bendigo.
Coming. Oh, she's got space. She had space. Step back off the window for two.
Now you want to make sure they don't shoot a three. You don't foul them.
Both sides in the bonus, remember. Mitchell. 50 to play. 10 on the shots. Oh, hey. Inside. Pedersen.
You may get your overtime.
I've waited all season. Steph coming. Thought about the three. Townsville. 10 on the shot clock.
They need to score here.
Standish. McCulley. Oh, ball at the top. Susie again. Oh, she's on the handle. Foul. Foul. The foul has been called with 2 seconds on the shot clock.
Oh, the fans aren't happy.
That might be popular, but it was there.
Yeah, it was definitely there.
Kayla Pedersen has 4 personal fouls.
don't know about the coaches and the players, but my heart rate is right up right now.
There are 18 seconds remaining in the game. Susie Bakovic is at the line for two.
Oh dear. I don't know about your overtime now.
The margin is one. Timeout has been called. Understandably so. 72-71. WNBL on ABC One. There is Mark Wright.
Well, so for Dandenong, you need to now go. We're 1 point down. So we need to get a shot up, the first best available shot. So you don't want to work the clock down to nothing. You need to get your first best available shot so that if you miss, you have a chance at an offensive rebound and a putback or a foul.
Let's see here what Townsville's thinking.
You've got Downey, all right? She's not getting no board, she's not getting a jumper. Okay, you've got it? All right, you stay at home on Peterson. All we need is a stop and a possession. That's all we need. All right, if you get hung up, Kayla, and you have to black, you need to talk to your teammates aggressively.
Yeah.
All right, so we got it, okay? If we get a stop, we actually don't have to shoot the basketball, all right? You got to look after it.
Easier said than done, though, for Chris Lucas. The thing is, though, Laurie, if they do take that shot early in the piece, it does make it, if they hit it, then it still gives the fire an opportunity.
Yeah, but you have to, I mean, that it does, but then they're in the same scenario at the other end, so you need to give yourself a chance to get a putback. He talked about no rebound for Allison Downey. You need to give yourself, if it misses, a chance to foul and stop the clock. So your first best shot, not just jack it up, but your first best available shot.
The ball has been advanced. 18 seconds remain in the prelim final. It's Townsville by one. Last play is to spec right here for the Rangers. Mitchell, this is pressure. Who's going to stand up? 11 seconds.
Well, of course, Jack. Ohay. Of course.
Ohay runs out of room. Kunek, 6 seconds. Lost a handle on it. It's out of play. They're going to foul immediately.
They need to foul straight away. Foul that.
They do. Now, if this is Kayla Pedersen, who's going to be assessed with this foul, she's out of the game. It is, and she's out. I don't think the Dandenong bench were quite looking for that. So Natalie Novosel has to check in. There are 2 seconds to play. Enough for a point shoot.
Well, it's a Hail Mary. It's, you know, we saw now Belinda Snell do it at the Olympics. Even if she makes both, they'll be down by three.
Unfortunately, too, Mark Wright has run out of timeouts, so they can't advance the ball. Novosel creeps into the Rangers' front court. McCulley makes 2 of 2. Oh, hey! Hail Mary! No good! What a win for this Townsville Fireside! They've done it 2 years in a row! What a performance! They've stood up under immense pressure. And they're into the grand final. Townsville 74, Dandenong 71 here on ABC One. Wow, what a game. The Rangers had the last play. It didn't go for them. They just couldn't get there in the end. But what fight from this Townsville Fire lineup. They were under all sorts of pressure, had everything thrown at them. But they still stood up. They lead the head-to-head against Bendigo. That's got to be a factor heading into the grand final. Rachel McCulley, what a game for her. 13 points. She's there with Laurie.
Rachel McCulley, another grand final. Congratulations.
Thank you so much. Oh, that was an absolute grind. And we knew it was going to be, but, well, the girls hung tough. We got it done in the end.
I tell you what, it was, there were so many momentum swings in that game, and we were actually secretly hoping for overtime. But those last few minutes, basket for basket, you guys just held your nerve.
Yeah, we did. that was a great game of women's basketball, and yeah, but the girls just hung tough. It was awesome.
Well, you just played such a captain's role out there today. You were superb. I'm not even sure of your stats. I was too excited to look at them, Rachel. But you controlled the tempo. You got some big baskets, and you were just so steady out there.
Yeah, it was a good little battle I had with Leilani as well. She was doing a good job. She had some big shots down the stretch, but that's my role, and I was happy what I did today. And we get the win, we get the win. I couldn't care about the stats, but yeah, the win is what we wanted.
Well, it is like Groundhog Day. You are back facing Bendigo next week. Have you even thought that far ahead?
No. We were just thinking one game at a time, and to make another one, get another crack at Bendigo is what we wanted. And we're there now, so now it's just going to be who comes to play on the day.
Well, you do get another crack at Bendigo. All the best. Well done, Rachel.
Thanks. See you guys.
And she's going to play game number 300 next week. And she is very, very excited, and understandably so. It's been a big win for this Townsville Fireside. Oh, gee, it was a nail-biter last week. It's a nail-biter this week as well. How's the coach feeling? Chris Lucas is with Laurie.
Well, last week when I interviewed them, Chris Lucas had a big sigh, and I think he does again today. Chris, do you feel like you've just played 40 minutes of basketball?
Yeah, what another game, wasn't it? Another finals, and we had a game plan, and I'm pretty happy with most of it, to be quite honest. And I like to think we, Susie was down tonight, but we played as a team, and other people stepped up, and I'm absolutely stoked to make another grand final.
Well, I think you just hit the nail on the head there when you said Susie didn't have her best game, but you had so many other contributors. It looked like you really had your scouts down well on Danny Nong, and they really stuck to the game plan.
Yeah, look, the coaching staff, we spent a lot of time during the week it was more about individual scouts. We knew Jenna was going to get her points. She's just a wonderful player. But, I think for anybody to say it's only about Susie and our group's making a big mistake, because I think we played a hell of a team game today.
Absolutely. Now you're on your way to Bendigo again, Chris. Bernie Harrow was in the crowd watching.
Thought he might be.
Do you have any thoughts about next week, or have you even gone down that path?
Oh, look, I'm just so proud of the girls. I think, just enjoy tonight, keep it pretty relaxed. We'll head back in the morning, and then we'll come back Thursday, Friday. I think, two regional teams in the grand final again, obviously it's fantastic for the game. And, we would like to have something special happen for Townsville, and nobody's ever won a grand final in Townsville, so if we can do that, it'll be creating history in the town.
Well, congratulations on another fantastic preliminary win, and good luck in the grand final.
Thank you.
Yeah, very, very happy. Townsville Fire coach there, Peter Mercado. Isn't it incredible? Townsville cannot beat Dandenong except in a preliminary final.
It's an extraordinary run that they've had, and they've done it again. This time they had the home final along the way. And I can tell you, as we look at the stats there, have a look at the offensive rebounds, 13-9. That was the key. They got it done on the defensive boards as well. And their shooting percentages were pretty good there, 42% to 39. But I can tell you, this will be the talk of Townsville for the whole week. They just love it up there. And to see a team that could actually win a title from far north Queensland will just be amazing to see. And as we go through the stats there, an amazing performance again by Jenna O'Hay, 27 points, just couldn't grab the W there. Leilani Mitchell and Alice Kunek with 15 points each. And there you can see the spread from the Fire players. They spread it out nicely. Steph Cumming with 15 points, and then a couple with 13 as well. It was a very even performance, as Chris Lucas was talking about.
Yeah, indeed. And Laurie Chiswick, I know that both of you thought it was going to go to overtime, particularly when it was level scores. But then Susie Batkovic missed one. And did you think that Dandenong was in then, Laurie?
Well, I thought, to be honest, I thought that Dandenong, would have got a better shot than they... Well, look, I mean, Townsville played great defense out there. I thought when Susie only made one, that just left the door open for Dandenong.
Well, Peter, next week we are in Bendigo. What are you expecting here? These sides have got interesting stats head-to-head.
They do, and interestingly enough, Townsville actually lead that head-to-head. Mind you, the last time they did play, Bendigo had a massive win, but look at those results. Round 1, but also round 15, and you can see there Townsville getting the win away from home. So they've got that head-to-head split, and Laurie, surely that's got to count for something.
Well, I think it does, and the fact that, when I was thinking about Bendigo, who would they rather play? They probably would have rather played Dandenong just because they've beaten them so many times in a row, whereas Townsville have had those couple of wins, so that'll lead to their self-belief. But I tell you what, it will be tough again in Bendigo. Their crowd is loud. It'll be packed. and they've got some star quality players.
Yeah, I think you're right about the preference of Bernie Harawa, because you just never know which game Townsville's going to bring. They can make it very, very difficult. But as Laurie said, Peter, Bendigo, it's going to be tough. Their whole community gets behind them.
Exactly. Well, we talk about Christy Harawa being the focal point for Bendigo, but as Chris Lucas pointed out when he was talking with you, Laurie, he's saying our team's not about Susie Bakovic. It's not necessarily about Christy Harawa. They have built that program over the last couple of years, and they've got game winners all over the floor. So you might shut one player down, you might shut Gabe Richards down, but then all the other players will step up.
Well, I think you'd have to say that these two teams that are in the grand final epitomize what we call team basketball. They share the ball around. They've got some legitimate superstars, each of them, but the fact is that anybody can score on a night. They've got lots of contributors out there. They really like playing together as a team, and so you know what? The two teams that are in the final, I think, are totally deserving.
Well, Laurie, Peter managed to keep you out of your coaching role and well in your commentary role here today. But what do you think Bernie Harawa would have taken from today? What is he looking out for in Townsville?
Well, I think just what we mentioned, that it's not all about Susie, that he's got to, control the likes of Rachel McCauley. Steph Cumming came alive in that second half. And even the role players, Rosie Fledelvik and certainly Alex Wilson came in and played some really valuable minutes. So you can't underestimate anybody. They'll know the shuffle offense. They'll do their scouts against that. They'll be ready. But, he would have enjoyed watching that game today and seeing the battle.
Peter, how about the matchups here, especially among the guards? It's going to be very interesting indeed.
It's going to be extraordinary, and you can see every single matchup. We're going to go through a couple of the key ones here. Are just going to be crucial to this game. We saw Kelly Wilson, Michaela Cox there. We're going to work out who's going to take on Christy Harawa. Is it going to be Leilani Mitchell? And you see how the players match up, and you look through it and you think, it's pretty even, and there can be lots of interchanges between those matchups. What we see on the screen may not be how they line up next week.
No, well, we know that sometimes they put a taller player on Christy, and so that can be a plan. I think we'll see a little bit of zone from Townsville as well. They'll just mix it up, and I think both coaches did a good job of doing that tonight, mixing up their defenses, mixing up their matchups, and I'm sure that'll be what we see next week as well.
Yeah, it'll be a very, very interesting match there all round. In fact, in all positions on the court, and especially the bigs as well. They will prove to be very, very exciting to watch with Gabe Richards and Susie Bakovic. But, guys, tell us, Kelsey Griffin, how important?
Oh, hugely important. What a season she's had. And you talk about how even that side is. You've got Kelsey Griffin there, but you've also got players like Chelsea O'Brien, who gives them quality minutes all the time as well. It's just extraordinary. But who's going to match up on her, Laurie?
Well, I think Kelsey Griffin, we can say, is a big game player. She loves the scene of finals. She loves the big game atmosphere. She was MVP in the grand final last year. And again, I think you're going to have to put a multiple of players on her. So you can start with maybe a Kayla Standish. Maybe a Mia Newley will go on her, depending whether she's in the three or four spot as well. So I think it's a matter of throwing different looks at her, because she is such a big game player. She'll get comfortable with any one person.
And the thing is, you shut her down, but there are three other players who could step up. That's the thing about this game. You've got someone, as I mentioned, like a Chelsea O'Brien, who could start lighting it up.
Well, Sarah Blikovs as well. With both teams there, and that's why they're in the grand final. That's why they're had the success that they've got. They've got depth, they've got star quality, and they play like a team.
Now, you mentioned earlier that there's five players on the court and all of them are equally capable for both these sides. Gabe Richards, what role do you see her playing? Will it be solely a Susie Bakovic role?
Well, I think that we'll see that those two matched up a lot of the time, and it'll be great. It'll be fascinating to see Gabe try and use her body against Susie. Susie's got a little bit of a height advantage on her. But again, it might change a little bit. You know, and when you go into a zone, that sort of relieves the pressure of having to just guard Gabe all on your own. But it'll be a very intriguing matchup.
It'd be interesting to see the early foul count. I mean, Susie had two fouls today in the opening quarter, had to sit down for extended minutes. It'd be the same going back the other way. If Gabe Richards gets into foul trouble early on in the game, they sit down. It's a matter of how the teams can actually adjust to that if that actually occurs.
Well, I think both teams have a little bit of depth. We know that Kayla Standish started on the bench, so when Susie got into foul trouble, she was able to come in. Now, she's used to starting some of those times, so that was pretty easy for her to come in. And same thing with Bendigo.
if Gabe get into foul trouble, well, there's people, they can then move Kelsey into the bigger spot and move Sarah in. So, I mean, they've had to replace Elise Pantaluna already, so they're quite capable of moving players around.
Now, guys, now we come to the very, very tough question. Who's going to win next week, Peter Mercado, and why?
Can I say overtime again? I know we still have to get a winner out of that.
It's always your fallback.
I'm hoping it's going to be a close game. And look, I'm going to say Bendigo. I mean, they've had the week off this week. Townsville have done the travel. They're going to have to do it again. They've played two really hard games. Again, they won't be the favourite to win, but even still, you just feel like Bendigo have had such a superb season. They're so even all over the floor, and I think they can get it done.
Well, if you have to make a tip, I think I'd go with Bendigo too, home court advantage, the travel for Townsville. I think it'll be closer than last year. I think Townsville are in a better position this year than they were last year to actually really give this final a crack. It was a good game last year, but I think this year it'll go down to the wire. But I still think it'd be hard-pressed not to pick Bendigo.
Oh, I think you're probably right.
You know,
of course. Now, this game was an absolute blinder. We didn't get overtime, but wow, Dandenong Rangers taking on Townsville Fire, the preliminary final. It ended up with the same result as last year, the Townsville Fire winning that one, but you can relive it. Wednesday, 3:30 a.m. if you're an early bird, or anytime on iView. Next week, guys, 3 p.m., the WNBL Grand Final, the season finale, the big one. It's Bendigo Spirit and Townsville Fire. Can't wait for that one. Guys, you're all prepped. Are you ready?
Oh, I'm going to start walking to Bendigo now. That's how excited I am about this game. It's just going to be incredible. What a way to finish off what has been such a high standard of basketball.
And Laura, just quickly, two worthy teams meeting in the big one?
Absolutely. And it is, as Chris said, it's great to have two regional teams in there. The town of Bendigo will be going crazy. And I know there were lots of Townsville supporters here today. And I bet we'll see a lot of them out next week as well.
Yeah, Bendigo Townsville, 3 o'clock next Sunday. Make sure you join us, the WNBL Grand Final. Thanks for your company today, and we'll see you then.